When the ruler knows his heart, the people are simple and pure. When he meddles with their lives, they become restless and disturbed. Bad fortune is what good fortune leans on. Good fortune is what bad fortune hides in. Who knows the ultimate end of this process? Is there no norm of right? Yet what is normal soon becomes abnormal. People's confusion is indeed long-standing. Thus the master is content to serve as an example and not to impose his will. He is pointed, but does not pierce. He straightens, but does not disrupt. He illuminates, but does not dazzle. Tao. In the Tao. Governing people and serving nature, nothing surpasses thrift and moderation. Restraint begins with giving up one's own ideas. This depends on virtue gathered in the past. If there's a good store of virtue, then nothing is impossible. If nothing is impossible, then there are no limits. If a man knows no limits, he is fit to lead. This is the way to be deeply rooted and firmly planted in the Tao, the secret of long life and lasting vision. The secret of long life and lasting vision. Governing a large country is like frying a small fish. You spoil it with too much poking. Approach the universe with the Tao and evil will have no power. Not that evil is not powerful, but its power will not be used to harm others. Not only will it not do harm to others, but the sage himself will also be protected. Only the ruler and his people would refrain from harming each other. All the benefits of life would accumulate to the kingdom. Great country is like the lowland. toward which all streams flow. It is the reservoir of all under heaven, the feminine of the world. The female overcomes the male with stillness by lowering herself through her quietness. So if a great country lowers itself before a small one, it wins friendship and trust. And if a small country can lower itself before a great one, it will win over that great country. The one wins by stooping, the other by remaining low. Non-action. The true nature, the secret source of everything. It is the treasure of the good man and the refuge of the bad. If a person seems wicked, do not cast him away. Awaken him with your words. Elevate him with your deeds. Repay his injury with your kindness. Do not cast him away. Cast away his wickedness. Thus, when a new leader is chosen, do not offer to help him with your wealth or your expertise. Help him to meditate on the principles. Offer instead to teach him about the Tao. Practice non-action. Work without doing. Taste the tasteless. Magnify the small. Increase the few. Reward bitterness with care. See simplicity in the complicated. Achieve greatness in little things. Take on difficulties while they are still easy. Do great things while they are still small. The sage does not attempt anything very big, and thus achieves greatness. If you agree too easily, you will be little trusted, because the sage always confronts difficulties. He never experiences them. At rest is easily managed. What is not yet manifest is easy to prevent. The brittle is easily shattered. The small is easily scattered. Act before things exist. Manage them before there is disorder. Remember, a tree that fills a man's embrace grows from a seedling. A tower 9 stories high starts with 1 brick. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Act and destroy it. Grasp it and lose it. The sage does not act, and so is not defeated. He does not grasp, and therefore does not lose. People usually fail when they are on the verge of success. So give as much care at the end as at the beginning. Then there will be no failure. The sage does not treasure what is difficult to attain. He does not collect precious things. He learns not to hold on to ideas. Sage does not act. Helps the 10,000 things find their own nature, but does not venture to lead them by the nose. The ancient ones were simple-hearted and blended with the common people. They did not shine forth. They did not rule with cleverness. So the nation was blessed. When they think that they know the answers, people are difficult to guide. When they know that they do not know, people can find their own way. Not using cunning to govern a country is good fortune for the country. The simplest pattern is the clearest. Content with an ordinary life, you can show all people the way back to their own true nature. Why is the sea king of 100 streams? Because it lies below them. Humility gives it its power. Why is the sea king of 100 streams? Because it lies below them. Humility gives it its power. Therefore, those desiring a position above others must speak humbly. Those desiring to lead must follow. Thus it is that when a sage stands above the people, they do not feel the heaviness of his weight. And when he stands in front of the people, they do not feel hurt. The sage stays low, so the world never tires of exalting him. He remains a servant, so the world never tires of making him its king. All the world talks about my Tao with such familiarity. What folly. The Tao is not something found at the marketplace or passed on from father to son. It is not something gained by knowing or lost by forgetting. If the Tao were like this, it would have been lost and forgotten long ago. Desiring to lead must follow. desiring to lead must follow. Those desiring to lead must follow. Three treasures which I hold fast and watch closely. The first is mercy. The second is frugality. The third is humility. From mercy comes courage. From frugality comes generosity. From humility comes leadership. Now if one were bold but had no mercy, if one were broad but were not frugal, if one went ahead without humility, one would die. Love vanquishes all attackers. It is impregnable in defense. When heaven wants to protect someone, does it send an army? No. It protects him with love. A good soldier is not violent. A good fighter is not angry. Good winners do not contend. Good employers serve their workers. The best leader follows the will of the people. All of them embody the virtue of non-competition. This is called the virtue of non-contending. This is called employing the power of others. This, since ancient times, has been known as the ultimate unity with heaven. There is a saying among soldiers, I dare not make the first move, but would rather play the guest. I dare not advance an inch, but would rather withdraw a foot. This is called going forward without advancing, pushing back without using weapons. There is no greater misfortune than feeling I have an enemy. For when I and enemy exist together, there is no room left for my treasure. Thus, when two opponents meet, the one without an enemy will surely triumph. Armies are evenly matched. The one with compassion wins. My teachings are very easy to understand. And very easy to practice. Yet so few in this world understand, and so few are able to pray.
Do you see?
My words have an ancestor. My deeds have a Lord.